once again to the English class. Do you remember me? Who am I? Yes, I am your English teacher. In my previous video, I told you my name also. Do you remember my name? Yes, very good children. My name is Mrs. Priyadarshini. Yes, I am handling your English subject and I am the class teacher of 4th C. It's very nice to see you all in the classes, children. You all are watching your classes. Very nice. Your parents are giving us the feedback. Yes, child is watching the video. They are understanding. Really, it makes us to feel happy. Very good, children. Continue it. You don't lose the interest. You need to continue. If you study regularly, then you can achieve the good marks. You can score good marks. You can achieve the highest place. No? Very nice. So, obey your parents. I told you about this obedience. No? You need to obey your parents. Listen to them. What they tell, you have to listen to them. You all are listening. It's very nice. Good children you all are. No? Very good. And I told you also to pray. Every day you need to pray. Are you all following that? Are you praying? Morning, early morning when you get up, you should thank God. You need every day to thank God. Without prayer, don't start your day, children. Prayer is very essential in our life. Because of prayers, we are alive. We are having so many answers for our prayers. And so many miracles are taking place in our life. We need to pray to God. We need to thank God for the good parents, for giving us good life. You got a life, no? That is from God Almighty. You need to pray, thank God. Without God, can you do the work? No, it's impossible. It is impossible. Only you can live. But without God, it is impossible to live. And thank God. God such a good parents. So many children, they have lost their parents in this pandemic. In the second wave, you have heard in the news. The children have lost their parents. Some have become orphan. They have lost both the parents. Some lost mother. Some lost the father. So many disasters have taken place, children. So you are really very blessed. So you need to thank God for your parents. And your parents are working hard to earn money so that they can give you the comfortable and luxurious life. Isn't it? Yes, they work hard. They go morning for the duty. They work from morning till evening. Again, they fulfill all your needs, all your wants. So you need to thank God for your parents and you pray for the safety of your parents as they are going for the duty. When they are going, you just close your eyes for a second and pray, God, keep an angel to guard over my parents. Whenever they are going, you protect them. You need to pray for your parents like this. And also, you should pray for your teachers. Your teachers are struggling hard. We are coming to school, children, because of the learning process. Your learning process should be continuous, no? So we are all are learning online through links. So you need to pray for your teachers. We too are taking so much risk and we are leaving our family back and we are working for you all. So you need to pray for your teachers also. And along with the teachers, elders are there. So many elderly people, they are going into depression because they have to sit in the house for a long time. Is it possible? No. No, no? Yes. It is not possible. But this period, they are going into depression because at home they are telling, senior citizens, please don't go out. Senior citizens, don't stand out. So many restrictions are there, right? So you pray for the all the elderly people, old people, old age people. Okay, children? Very nice. These points you remember. and you all are very little ones, little angels, no? God will listen to your parents more than us. Your prayers will be heard quickly. So you need to pray for all these people. So remember these points. Okay, children? Shall we move to the class? Yes. In my previous video, I have taught you one poem. Which was the poem? Yes, it is I Want to Fly. It is the first poem. First poem of your fourth standard. What is the name of the poem? I Want to Fly. This was the name of the poem. Do you remember? What did I teach in that video? Yes, I taught you about the poem. 10 lines of the poem I have explained. And this poem is about a wish. Who had the wish? A little girl, no? A little girl. The poet. The poet had a wish. In this poem, you have seen a little girl. She was having a wish. What wish? She wanted a pair of wings. So when she had a pair of wings, what she wanted to do? She want to fly. Fly where? Up in the sky. Straight up in the sky. Then, what she want to do there? Simply she want to fly? No. She want to carry a brush also and colors, bright colors. She want to carry brush, paints along with her. For what? To sit and draw? No. Yes. She want to color every cloud whichever way she can see. Whichever it comes into her sight, she want to color those clouds. And what color she has used there? Yes, purple, yellow, green, no? And these colors, when we color it, the things look pretty, no? So she was telling that you will see the clouds which are prettiest, which you have not seen at all, no? I have explained till these lines. So very nice, children, you still remember it. And I told you to read the poem, right? 10 lines, that is first 10 lines of the poem. You need to read, learn, practice the spellings. In my video, I have taught you some spellings, no? You need to. So children, don't worry about the textbook. And every time parents are asking, Miss, we are not getting the textbook, when you will give? So don't worry about the textbook. I have sent a link, PDF link. You can download that link and you'll get the full textbook. What you have in form of printed, no? You can download that textbook. It will remain in your mobile. Okay, children? And if you don't, if you particularly want the textbook only, you can borrow from your neighbors. You can borrow from your neighbors, your relatives, or if you know any person who is staying next to your house, you can borrow the textbooks from them and you can use it till you get the new one. Okay, children? Don't worry about the textbook and don't ask parents, give me books. Because parents are helpless. We didn't give the textbook because we didn't get from the department. Okay, children? Understand the problem and try to cooperate. If you cooperate, it will be very smoothly. We can handle the things. Okay, shall we go to the poem? Are you all ready? Because I used to tell open the textbook, but I'm helpless. I cannot tell open the textbook. So just listen to me. I will send the link and once more I'll send you the page, which page I have taken. You can read in that. Okay, ready? Right. First I'll read from the beginning, then we'll go for today's one. Unit 1. I want to fly. If I had a pair of wings with which to fly, I'd soar straight away up into the sky. I'd carry a brush and paint in colors bright, so I could paint every fluffy cloud in sight. I'd paint them purple and yellow and green. They'd be the prettiest you have ever seen. So some words I have given you the meanings. Once again, I'll be writing at the end of the lesson some words and meanings. You'll see the next two stanzas of the poem. I'd paint rainbows in the sky every single day. So the poet is telling, I'd paint rainbows. Where is this rainbow? Where you can see the rainbow? Yes, you can see this rainbow. What is the shape of this rainbow? Yes, it is an arch. It is in an arch shape, no? Can you see this every day? No. When you can see? Only when? Sometimes, not every day, it appears in the sky when the sunshine passes through the rain. Sun rays, when it passes through the rain, when it is raining, if the sun rays, when the sun rays passes through this rain, you can see the rainbow. It is in an arch form. See the rainbow. How many colors are there, children, in rainbow? Many, no? No? Yes. Some particular number is there. What is that number? Seven colors. Yeah? Seven colors in the rainbow. So the poet is telling, I'll paint rainbows in the sky every single day. He wants to color these rainbows soon. Every single day, so I can watch them when I work at play. Watch means not your watch, wrist watch you wear, no, that which shows the timing, which measures the timing, not that watch. Watch is different word here. Watch will give you the different meaning here. The meaning of watch is to look. To look at something. Do you understand? What is the meaning of watch? Watch here in the poem, it means that to look at something. So the poet want to look at the rainbow. When he want to look? While playing and working. So I can watch them when I work and play. The poet want to watch the rainbow by working and playing. So when you are playing, if you see something in the sky, what you do? You call everybody, no? You call your parents. If something, aeroplane, for example, if aeroplane is in the sky, what happens? You run, you call your parents, you call your friends, brothers, sisters, hey, come, see what is there in the sky, you know. Sometimes you can see just a fluffy ray or like a rainbow, no? You can see like this light passing, no? That is, you see a rocket, no? All this you have experience. And since this is a rainy season, children, you can see the rainbow sometimes. When you see, you click the picture and just observe the colors of the rainbows. So this poet also want to watch the rainbow while working and playing. And when the moon and stars come out at night, see the wish of the poet. He is wishing to color this moon and stars. Is it possible? What are these moons and stars? These are the heavenly bodies. Where you can see? In the sky, no? You have learnt in EVS, no? Yes, very good, children. See, this poet is wishing to color the moon and stars. When you can see these moons and stars? Night. So the poet is wishing to color this moon and stars when it comes out in the at night. Perhaps I will paint them too for my delight. What he is telling? Perhaps. Perhaps means uncertain. The meaning of perhaps is uncertain. or joy or happiness or happy. No, this word is having different meanings. You can use any one of the meaning. See the poet. He is wishing to color these heavenly bodies, and he is telling that I feel happy when I see this moon and star. When I color it, he feels happy. He want to feel that happiness. So he is wishing all. So the poet is he want to feel the joy of coloring these heavenly bodies. When he wish to have the pair of wings, he want to fly, and he want to color all these heavenly bodies which you can see in the sky. So usually these clouds, moon, stars, you can see in the sky. You cannot go, you cannot travel to these heavenly bodies. There are specialized people, they travel to study. So many scientists are there, they are on the earth, but they study the moon and stars. And some people are there, they have traveled to this moon and stars. So this poet, he is just trying to make happen. It cannot be true, no? Only he is wishing. He is having a wish to travel in the sky and color all these things. And when you color these things, you can see the things, they look very pretty. So usually when you draw something, what you do? If you don't color, how is the picture? It is not so good, no? When you color it, it looks very beautiful. With bright colors, when you use the dark colors, bright colors, the picture will look more attractive. No? When you wear good dress, what happens? You look very attractive. Same way the poet want to color with the bright colors and make the things attractive. His wish is to make all the things look beautiful, more attractive. No? So this poem, it ends here, children. So some of the words we learn and some meanings. Because in English language, you should know the words and meanings in all the languages, especially English, Kannada, Hindi, Telugu, Tamil, any languages if you take, you need to know the words, and along with the words, you should know the meanings. You are learning the words and meanings, no, right from second standard or third standard. It's very nice. So this year also you'll be learning some of the words and meanings. In this textbook, there are no words and meanings. But I am giving you some extra words which are there from the poem. You need to know the meanings. Then only you can understand the poem. And you can use those words when you are talking, when you are communicating with the other people. So you need to know the words and meanings. Shall we go for the words and meanings? Right from the first stanza we'll start, okay? Snow, S-O-A-R, snow, fly, high. See, when I am writing, I am reading the words in the sky. So children, when you are writing also, no, you need to read and write. That will be very helpful for you to remember the things. What you have written, what you have read, no need of reading again and again. While writing only, you make it a habit, say the words loudly, read loudly, then go on writing. Okay? Snow, fly high in the sky. Fluffy. Soft and light. So what is soft and light, children? Anything you have seen? pillows, no? You have a cotton teddy bear, very nice. You all like, no? It will be light and it is soft. You, when you touch that teddy bear, what happens? You feel smooth fur, no? That is called fur. So fluffy means smooth, soft and light. So whenever fluffy is there, remember teddy bear. Eh? So you can connect that word. It is soft and light. Side. Ability. Ability to see. Ability to see. Read the words, children. Okay? When you read, then only you can tell the poem, you can recite. You need to read loudly. Prettiest. Which degree it is, I told you? Superlative degree, no? Yes, very good. Pretty means attractive. Pleasant to look, look at or hear. See, I can give you only attractive or pleasant, but it contains here attractive, pleasant to look. Some things are attractive and pleasant to look, that is see, and some are attractive and pleasant to hear. Sometimes when you talk wrong things, what happened? Is it good? Is it pleasant? No. So prettiest means attractive, pleasant to look at or hear. Watch. W-A-T-C-H. Watch, no? What is this watch? In the poem. See, whenever this watch is related in the poem. So, this word is having different meaning. You need to write here. Because in different situation, this word will give you different meaning. So, here in the poem. Here in the poem, different meaning. So many meanings will be there for this word. So in the poem, this watch means to look at something or someone. Okay. So what is the meaning of watch here? Watch. So you should read here. Here means in the poem. The watch meaning in the poem is to look at something. Okay? Perhaps. Uncertain. Perhaps is uncertain. Delight. Great pleasure or happiness. You can tell happy. Okay? Delight, great pleasure or joy or happy. So this word or means you can write any one meaning. Or means you can write any one meaning. So these are the words, children. Snow, fly high in the sky. Fluffy, soft and light. Sight, ability to see. Prettiest, attractive, pleasant to look at or hear. Watch, hear, to look at something. Perhaps uncertain. Delight, great pleasure or joy or happy. So these are the words in the poem. I have given you the meanings. You can observe one thing, children, here. In this words and meanings, I have not started the word with a capital letter. Because when you are writing words and meaning, it should be small letters in the beginning. Can you observe here? S is small, F is small, S small, P, watch, W small, P, D. Because in English language, you can observe the dictionary also. The words in the dictionary, it begins with small letter. You may be thinking, teachers have taught us, always we have to begin the first letter with the capital letters. That is in the sentence. There are some rules and regulations you need to follow. So when you are writing these words and meanings, the word when you are writing, it should be, beginning letter, it should be small. And you can observe the meaning also. You can see the meanings, which is also beginning with the small letter. So in your previous classes, you used to put dash in between the words and meanings. So don't put dash, just draw a line, children. You need to learn all this, okay? So I'll be sending you one video, how to start your notes, that is English CW. Don't worry, I'll send you first one lesson, neatly how it should be written, okay? You can watch that video, then you can start your notes. So you can follow these rules. Words and meanings, you need to write with the small letter. No need of writing the capital letters. Okay? Is that clear? Right, children. So this was about the words and meanings. So this was about the poem. You have learnt a new poem, I want to fly. So you two all fly, no? Now when you are reading this poem, when you are reciting this poem, you can fly and you can recite the poem. You can read. Okay, children? You can act like a bird. No? You can act like a bird. With the actions, you can do this reciting of the poem with actions. You can create your own actions. You all are very good choreographer. You have learned dance. You know, nowadays you are doing many curricular activities, extracurricular activities. Recite the poem with the action. You have learned, you know, in LKG, UKG, teachers, they used to teach you the rhymes with the action. So in this fourth standard also, you stand in front of the mirror and do some actions. Then you recite the poem along with the recitation. You can dance and you can enjoy the poem. So that's all about this poem, children. See you in the next class. Till then, be alert, be safe to control this coronavirus. Okay? And very shortly, we are hearing the third wave will start. So don't worry. So you need to be alert, wear mask, maintain social distance, and use sanitizer. Don't go out of the house unnecessary. Okay, children? See you. Bye-bye.